Hello, I'm David Jones from Presto Music School. I'm about to break down that little intro piece there for you in our series, How to Play the Blues. If you like what you're seeing and like what you're hearing, please do consider subscribing and hit that little bell notification so that you obviously get notified next time we have a video up. In the meantime, let's get cooking and learn how to play some of those ideas in that piece. If you haven't already done so and you need to, check out lessons one and two, and then once you're all sorted, move on to four. Anyway, on with lesson three. If you haven't already gone through the blues fingering exercises and basic theory video, then I strongly recommend you have a little look at that. But just to recap, make sure that that left hand you have nice and strong and solid, and you've practiced that and rehearsed it round and round so that your fingers are nice and strong, because of course that will help. And second of all, make sure that you've practiced your blues scale round and round so that that's nice and strong and solid and secure. And also those little third exercises that we did in lesson one and two, make sure that you've gone through those exercises as well so that your fingers are nice and warmed up and you've got the basic understanding of what we need to base this lesson on. If you remember in lesson two, we had a little look at this kind of figure. And going back to lesson one, we just looked at the blues scale. So if we start to put some of those ideas together, so there I've got my movement of thirds in the right hand, that kind of pattern. And we'll mix that up by going up a little bit, down. So you're going, to give us a new different kind of mix of the two patterns we've seen so far. So there again, moving the pattern around that we had in thirds, and then moving around the blues scale. If we then take that same idea but apply it to F, keeping it nice and strong and solid with your fingers and very rhythmic. So you need a really good, strong, punchy sound, making sure that you're hitting the keys so that it's fortissimo, or at least forte, all the way through. That's not to say that you can't have some dynamic shaping in the melody, but for the most part, it is nice and firm in the fingers, so you get that strong, bright, punchy tone from the piano. In that intro section, you heard this kind of idea as well, which again is just based on the movement of thirds in and around the blues scale, including notes from the major scale as well. And speaking of the major scale, when we come to the chord of G, that's again just movement of thirds around the major scale, and then using this kind of idea, which is an F7 shape here with the ninth at the top, that kind of pattern, and then a very common blues type figure here starting on the sharp four from the blues scale. So you can see that that pattern actually starts on notes which are based on the chord, and then moving more towards the blues scale of the key that we're in. We're in the key of C. So there is part of the blues scale of C, and finishing off with a minor third to major third, C7 on the end. Let's have a little look at the rhythms now that are used in that little intro piece. The left hand is using pretty much eighth notes throughout, and so is the right hand for the most part. You can see that both hands have got a very, very similar rhythm throughout, that both hands aren't necessarily playing at exactly the same time all the way through, because whereas the left hand is playing eighth notes all the way through, for a small amount of rhythmic variation, the right hand doesn't necessarily play on all of them. But as you can see, for the most part, you've got both hands playing at the same time, which makes the rhythms easier to put together, makes the coordination much easier. So whatever little patterns that you decide to come up with for yourself, whatever it may be, if you keep those rhythms nice and simple for now, when you put the two hands together, they become much easier to put together and to lock down and to get that rhythm nice and solid. The main thing though, before you start to put two hands together, is make sure that you absolutely have that left hand 1, 2, 3, 4 and absolutely solid all the way through, which will really make things easier to put two hands together. There's one more little thing, perhaps of a small amount of interest, is that fill that goes into bar five. This The other little idea that's in there is the fill that goes from bar four into bar five, which is the so that's a chord of C. That could be seen as D minor seven, D minor, but I've there doubled the seventh. E flat diminished 7, chord of E flat diminished 7 there. I've doubled there the C, and chord of C over E, perhaps with the 7th in there as well, which will pull you more easily and make a stronger cadence going to the chord of F, which is the beginning of the next bar.